Welcome to another live streaming tutorial. In this video, I'm going to show you how you can go ahead and start streaming to Twitch using OBS Studio. Let's go ahead and dive in. Alright, so the very first thing that we want to go ahead and do is we want to go ahead and determine what your internet speed is. This is so important because it's going to determine the kind of experience that your viewers are going to have. So I want you to go to speedtest.net, and I went ahead and put the link in the description along with any other link that I mentioned in this video. So once you're here, what you want to do is you simply want to select go. This is then going to go ahead and determine your ping, your download speed, and your upload speed. So the number that you want to focus on is going to be your upload speed. Now, I have a pretty high internet, but what you're looking for here is a figure that's higher than 5, typically around 10 or plus, right? To be able to get a good experience. If you have less than 5, then you're probably not going to be able to offer your viewers a great experience, but you're still going to be able to stream. So go ahead and note down that number or keep a mental memory of it, because we're getting ready to jump into the OBS settings and we're going to need to have that figure in mind. All right, so now that we establish your internet speed, the next thing we want to do is go ahead and set up Twitch inside of OBS Studio. So what you want to do is in OBS, you want to come to where it says settings, and this is going to go ahead and pop up a new window for us. The first thing that we want to do, and this is kind of like a pro tip, is that under general, you want to make sure that show confirmation dialog when starting and stopping streams is both checked. This way you never stop or start your stream accidentally. So once you go ahead and have that set up, you then want to come to where it says stream. You're going to want to go ahead and where it says service, you want to select Twitch, and then the next thing you want to do is you want to go ahead and connect account, which is the recommended route, and I'll show you why. So once you go ahead and click that, it's going to go ahead and prompt you to go ahead and get logged in. So you want to go ahead and input your information to go ahead and get logged in. And then once you're logged in, it's gonna go ahead and ask you to go ahead and provide a code. Now, what I like to do is hit resend code, check my phone, and then I'll see here in just a few moments that I have the code for my stream. So what that's gonna look like is gonna be here, 903661. I'll input that in there, and then it's gonna go ahead and authenticate my stream. Now, this is very important. Now, this is gonna be a little hack that I'm gonna show you how, regardless if you're a Twitch partner or a Twitch affiliate, you can have a high quality stream by simply checking this box here that says ignore streaming service settings recommendations. So make sure you have that check, because it's going to come in handy later. So you're going to go ahead and hit apply, and once you hit apply, you're going to see that you're going to have a chat window pop up here. So this is going to allow you to be able to go ahead and monitor your chat. So simply hit okay, and what you want to do is you want to go ahead and move this over until it's actually plugged in. So you'll see it there. And now here on the left hand side, you're going to be able to edit your stream title. You're able to go ahead and edit the notification, and the notification is what Twitch sends out to people who are following your stream. So you're able to customize that. You're able to add your category as far as if you're playing a game, if you're on a just chatting, and the tags. And I highly recommend you utilize tags that are relevant. This is just going to help your stream get found. And then your stream language, and then you simply hit done, and that's set up. And then on the right hand side, you're going to see here, this is where you're going to see the chat. This is the people that are going to be commenting and doing all the things in your stream. So once you have that established, that's going to be the first step. So what we want to do is you want to come right back to settings, and we're going to want to come to where it says output. This is going to be where we determine what kind of quality your stream is going to have and what kind of experience your viewers have as well. So under output mode, you're going to want to select advanced. Under encoder, you're going to want to select X264. Under rate control, you're going to select CBR. And now the bit rate, remember I tell you to make a mental note or to write down that upload speed. So this is where you're going to want to input that. If you have a speed that's 5 or higher, then you want to go ahead and copy what I'm going to show you here in just a moment. If it's less, try to put it at least 2500, 2300 to be able to give viewers a good experience. But here's the little hack. If you're not a Twitch partner or Twitch affiliate and you want to be able to have 1080p produced on your stream, you want to go ahead and have this at 7750 if it allows you to have that on based on your upload speed. Now, you may say, Curry, the max bit rate is 6000 on Twitch, but I'm telling you, this is the pro tip. Put it at 7750 and you'll see that you'll start to have 1080p 1080p quality streams with no issue. Then you want to go to keyframe intervals. You want to put that at 2. CPU usage, you want to put it at very fast. Profile, high. And then tune at 0 latency. Now, these are the settings that I use to be able to produce a high quality stream. And if you see some lag or you have some issues with your stream, just come in here and tweak the bit rate as you see fit. If it's lagging too much, drop this down a bit. If you have the space, keep it at 7,750. So now you want to do is you want to go ahead and hit apply so those settings stay saved. And then I want you to come down to where it says audio, and I want you to make sure that under mic, you select the mic that you're going to be utilizing. Then under video, this is very important. This is going to be how the stream is going to look to your viewers. So once you select videos, you want to have it at 1920 by 1080. The output scale, I would have it exactly the same. And then as far as the downscale filter, I have it by linear, right? Because we're going to be at 1920 by 1080. So have it there. It's going to give you a nice smooth quality. And then the common FPS value, you want to have it at 60 frames per second. You're simply going to hit apply. You're going to click OK. And now that's going to go ahead and give you the best settings to have the best quality for your Twitch stream. Now, if you want to know how to go ahead and add your gameplay overlay, how to go ahead and add a countdown screen, or how to even go ahead and have a stream intro like this, go ahead and watch this video right here where I show you how to go ahead and start adding sources and scenes and overlays inside of OBS. I'll see you in the next video.